If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life, there's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight.
You can't talk. You can talk right now.
We've all run into things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life.
You got pain. You gotta know where he's at.
He's a pain taker. He's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, oh, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel. Somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it. Somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it. Somebody testify. If you got pain.
What do you think shoot archery has got to do with life? Who? Food? Nuts? What else? What we just did, even this right here, what we just did?
Fun.
What else?
Competition.
Competition. What else?
Pass the time.
Yeah, pass the time away. What's that got to do with life? What we just did, I want you to think about a couple of different analogies about shooting bow and arrows, okay? In order to really be an effective hunter, you got to do what we just got to do, which is what?
Practice.
Practice. Practice. Practice. Practice. Right? 1 Timothy 4:7. Discipline yourselves for the purpose of godliness. Same exact same thing applies. In order for you to have an opportunity to ever become godly, you got to discipline yourselves for godliness. Don't just wake up one day and be godly. Don't wake up one day and just be able to go do this in the kingdom of God work. You got to discipline yourselves for the purpose of godliness. So there's a good analogy right there. If I want to, I'm going to practice to be a bow hunter. I'm going to practice to be a fisherman. I'm going to practice tomorrow shooting these skeet so I can be a better hunter. Well, the same thing applies in your life when it comes to you being a godly person too. Okay, it's practice. Secondly, what else does a good bow hunter, now I heard Brady mention it. What else does a good hunter, a good bow shooter have that helps him to make sure he's gonna hit the same place? Accurate. What helps him to be accurate? When you draw back, what do we call this right there?
That.
This is mine.
It's your anchor point.
Anchor point. If you don't have an anchor point, then this is what you're gonna do. If you're just drawing back on your bow and you don't have an anchor point, then your bow, your back hand is going to be all over the place, respectively speaking, to how it's going to hit the target every time, right? So you want an anchor point. You want something that whenever you pull back every time, you know, I used to put it on my thumb, my neck. All right there. That's where my release is, right there. So I know when I got my thumb on my neck, I'm right where I need to be. Some people put little corners in their mouth, the string in the corner of their mouth, and they know when they pull back, all right, that's one check off right there. My anchor point is set where I need to be, all right? In life, what could be a good anchor point? You need an anchor point in your life. Every one of you need an anchor point. You need something in your life that says, regardless of what happens in my life, this doesn't move. What is your anchor point? What's a good anchor point for you? You got any guesses? God's a good one. Yeah, obviously. But how? I mean, how do you experience God? How? Through what? Read the Word. God's Word is your anchor point. Whatever else happens in your life, listen to me, we talked about it last night. Whatever else happens in your life, regardless of what it is, when life seems like it's absolutely coming undone, when you've been gone off and you started doing all the things we try to get you not to do, and you started doing drugs and alcohol, and you're messing up, and you get some girl pregnant, and all of a sudden you got some kind of disease, and something, you lose your job, you lose this, and life just comes unfrazzled, there's one place you can always turn to, and that is God's Word. If you got a turkey, and he's gobbling over here, somewhere over here, and you're over here, and you're listening to him off this road, and you know he's somewhere in here gobbling, you can pull out your topo map, and you can look right here, oh, that's what he's on. He's over there, there's a ridge over there that he's on. And then you can navigate your way over there. You see, that's how you transfer knowing how to read a map into actually helping it make you learn how to hunt, okay? Now, also, deer and most wildlife are just like us. They don't want to walk straight up and straight down these steep bluffs. Anywhere you see these steep bluffs, okay, that's falling off. That's a big ridge top. That's falling off. And look over here at this map, because this land over here is a lot more hilly. This is the main property. This is where we are, okay? But now look at all these, look at all those contour lines. See how close all those lines are? What does that tell you about this property? When you look at that, what does that tell you about that property? What's it tell you? It's
real hilly.
It's real hilly. It's got what? It's got, see all this little, that's a ridge top, ridge top, ridge top, ridge top, ridge top, ridge top. And you can see all those, so that lets you know that's a steep, this right here is what you call a bluff. You see all those lines right there that are very close together? If you're hunting a place and you see that, most deer are not going to walk straight up and down that bluff. So you don't want to try to position yourself in a hunting stand close to that bluff to where you think a deer is going to walk up that bluff. They're just like you. They want to take the easiest route to wherever they go. What they will do is they will skirt that bluff. They will walk along the side of that bluff. So as you walk perpendicular against the bluff, you'll find trails that are going to be going crossways.
Acres. Acres. And deer eat acres, right? And they got a preference. Does anybody know what kind of tree this is?
That's a white oak.
Looking at the bark of it, first of all, what's white that oak tell you?
White oak.
No, it's an oak tree. Correct. But what kind of oak tree?
Post.
Nope.
White?
Nope.
White?
No, Bill. Not a white oak. We miss Bill right now. This is a water oak. The bark is typically smooth. It's a real tight bark. But I look at the bark, but also look at the leaf. I also look at the leaf of the tree, okay? See how the lobe on it is just a round, kind of a tear shape? See that? That's what a water oak leaf looks like, okay? Now, when you're looking at most of these leaves, when you see this, that is always going to signify a water oak. Now, walk over here and I'll show you the difference. What kind of tree is that right there?
White.
Nope.
Post.
Nope.
Live.
That's a poplar. That's not even an oak tree. The problem is you look at that and think, okay, hey, I got me a white oak right here because the bark's white and ain't no fruit on it. You're going to be sitting there wasting your time. You got to know your trees. If you're going to be an effectual deer hunter, you got to know your trees. What kind of tree is that right there?
Oak.
All right, if you look at the bark, you look at it, but now look at the leaves. What kind of leaves it look like?
Water
oak. Good job. Exactly right. But what do I have right here in front of you out through here? More than likely,
water.
Water. Exactly right. I don't care about a hickory. Deer don't eat a hickory. Squirrel eats a hickory. Deer will eat a hickory. Okay? I'm deer hunting. What have I got in this bottom right here, more than likely?
Water.
So what grows along the sides of water? Water oaks, oak trees, any kind of oak tree, right?
Oak.
So if I were going to set up a stand right here, what kind of tree do I have over here?
That's white oak.
Finally, you see a white oak. That is a white oak tree. That back there is a white oak tree.
Good job, baby.
This right here is a white oak tree. He's a prison shaking savior. You got chains. Oh, he's a chain breaker.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies, if you're trying to feel the same old holes inside, there's a better life, there's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker.
Move up.
If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life.